afternoon, everyone. When I first started with Toastmasters, I used to walk very fearful. And that, after a while, started to get a bit boring. It got a bit heavy. But today's graduation day, and I'm going from fearful to fabulous. How many of us agree that fear is false evidence appearing real? And it's not real, it's not the truth. But for some reason, fear ends up stifling us. It ends up hindering us. Just like you can either step into fear and be constricted and not be able to move, or you can step out of fear and into faith and just toss fear to the side and say, you know what, I don't care what my mind's telling me, I'm going to tell my mind that this is no more the day to be fearful, but it's the day to be fabulous. And I'm using these props as reminders that you have a choice. You can either wear this dark cloak of fear, or you could wear a bright, red, shiny robe and say, I'm fabulous. But it takes time, and it takes effort, and it takes the willingness to step out of your comfort zone. And as I am moving into the Pathways program, and this is my icebreaker speech, I decided I'm going to do something different. Instead of having speeches where I just work this area of the room, I decided, you know what, I'm going to step it up a notch, because I want to be that motivational speaker that I admire, that works the room, and that draws people in by their vocal variety and the movement that they make with their body. But most importantly, to leave you with a message and something to take back with you, which is fearful or fabulous. And the choice is ours. And we have that opportunity each day. Do we want to be the overcomers that kick fear out the door? Or do we want to be people that say, you know what, I can't do it today? And then you're carrying that fear on your back. But meanwhile, people might not see that you're walking in fear. And you know what? If you can't make it, fake it. So just for me, I'm looking at this opportunity as a way to say, you know what? This is a chance to be theatrical. This is a way to work the room and look at people's eyes and say, you can do it. You can break out of that fear, because I did. And even though my mind was telling me something else, I said, you know what, I'm not listening to you anymore. I'm going to do what I desire to do now, and that is to step out and to get out of my comfort zone and say, guess what, I'm going to be fabulous. Now, if you see me later on and I'm still wearing this, no problem. It's just a reminder to myself that I want to be fabulous instead of fearful. And I want to be that motivational speaker that other people look to and say, wow, I wish I could do that. I love the way they work the room. I like the way the vocal variety is. And what am I doing? I'm serving as an example. I'm serving as a role model. But I'm also getting myself more comfortable with saying, you know what? I don't have fear. So I don't fear the audience, because you're here to hear the message. You're here to be changed and transformed. So what is my job? To make the speech entertaining. To help you to see that you could have an entertaining speech too. Instead of just standing here like I did, and it was a growth process, just standing here and speaking because I had to focus on my words and, oh my gosh, what is the audience going to say? But now I say, you know what? Audience, you don't know what my speech is about. You don't know what my mannerisms are supposed to be. You don't know if I'm supposed to walk around the room, if I'm supposed to sit or stand. So you don't know. Whatever I'm presenting to you now, is it rehearsed or isn't it? That's what we have to look at, that kind of mindset. The audience doesn't have your cheat sheet of your speech. They're not reading all your punctuations and the movements that you put in the speech, like, I'm gonna say this, and then I'm gonna walk to the side here so I get this section of the audience. So no one can sleep now. No one can be on their phones. And you can't be thinking what's gonna be made for dinner. And then you come over here and you say, okay, this set of audience, you're not gonna sleep on me either. Because if I'm near you, you know that you have to be attentive. And if you want to be like my dad and try to master the art of sleeping with your eyes open, guess what? I'll be able to find which one of you is doing that. Not a Toastmaster.